Wednesday night, and the big story on Action News tonight is breaking news in South Philadelphia. A 55-year-old woman has been shot to death at 7th and Jackson, and she becomes the city's 500th homicide victim of the year. That ties the record of the largest number of murders in 1 year set back in 1990. The woman was rushed to Jefferson in critical condition but died there. No arrests have been made. And this happened on the same day that Philadelphia's leaders came together to address the scourge of gun violence and how it will claim an unprecedented number of lives before the year is out. Action News reporter Taronda Thomas is live in Center City. Taronda, what are the details on this?
Well, Jim, these are not the types of details that we like talking about. The 500 homicides that have happened so far this year, that's a 13% increase from this time in 2020, and it's nearly double the number of homicides that we saw at this time 5 years ago. You know, we are on track in Philadelphia to lose more lives to homicide this year than any other year on record. It's definitely not what you want to hear at a time where we should be giving thanks.
Tomorrow is Thanksgiving. And at least close to 500 families will not be the same ever again.
The holiday overshadowed by homicides.
Please stop shooting each other.
A plea from City Hall.
Stop the killers!
Stop the killers!
A demand from the streets of West Philadelphia.
A truce this Thanksgiving, and also a ceasefire.
This coalition of community members, leaders, and grassroots organizations takes the message to stop the killing door to door. They saw the city's press conference, but didn't hear enough solutions.
We need a plan that is cohesive, that makes a difference, and stops this craziness.
Because they say the talking at City Hall is not enough.
We're not really tripping on downtown. We're done with downtown. We're doing this right here.
City leaders actually agree solving the problem takes collaboration with the community.
There is a standing $20,000 reward for information that leads to an arrest and conviction for every unsolved homicide in our city.
A number of them likely committed with illegal guns.
It's easier to get a gun in Pennsylvania than it is to get a driver's license.
And they're also focused on providing young people with more opportunities and ways to heal their trauma.
We ain't the only city, but we're the one that got the courage to say we gonna win this one.
A battle that now has more boots on the ground.
Bring black life, we don't take black life!
Calling for an end to the violence.
That's what you see here today. A lot of powerful people here who are going to make it happen.
Now that group is actually signing people up to volunteer to go door to door to work for this ceasefire throughout the long holiday weekend. They're actually putting those boots on the ground to make a difference in Philadelphia that will last beyond things.